Hello, in this tutorial we are going to learn how to query MDNS service from an ASP32 and get the details of that service. In our case, the provider of that service will be another ASP32 and will make use of the code that we have used in a previous video where we explain how to advertise services, network services via MDNS. As target boards, I'm going to be using two Fire Beetle boards from DFRobot, so one of them will provide the service and the other will be the inquirer. So we'll start by the code of the ASP32 that will be providing the service. In this case, just to clarify, we are not actually implementing the service, we are just exposing or advertising a possible HTTP service over MDNS, but obviously in the real application scenario, we would implement here, for example, a web server, like we did in the previous tutorial, but to keep the focus on the resolution and on the inquiring of MDNS service, we are not going to add here the code to set up an HTTP server. We are just going to advertise as such, like such service was being provided by this ASP32. So looking into the actual code, the first thing we need to do, like before, is including the ASP MDNS library. This library is provided by default in the Arduino course, so we don't need to install any additional resource. And this will, in this case, it will allow us to set up an MDNS responder and also to advertise a service. Naturally, we also need the Wi-Fi.edge library, which will be needed for us to connect this ASP32 to a Wi-Fi network. Then, like we usually do, we define here two global variables that will load the network credentials, more precisely the network name and the network password. And naturally, you should replace these placeholders by the credentials that apply to your network. Then, moving on to the Arduino setup, we'll open a serial connection just for us to be able to output some results of our program. And then we'll take care of connecting the ASP32 to the Wi-Fi network using the credentials previously defined. So, from this point bottom, we are going to cover the MDNS part. The first thing we need to do is setting up our MDNS responder with a call to this begin method on the MDNS extern variable and passing as input a string with the host name that this ASP32 will have. So, in essence, when you want to reach this ASP32, this provider, we need to use this hostname that will be resolved using MDNS to a IP address. So this method returns as output of a boolean indicating if this initialization procedure was successful or not, and we are using it here just for a quick error checking, printing a message in case something goes wrong. Assuming that everything goes right and we can set up the MDNS responder, the only thing left to do is calling this addService method on our MDNS extern variable, passing us first input a string with the name of our service. Like I said before, I'm going to assume that we were exposing, for example, an HTTP web server. So we are going to call this server, this service HTTP. Then, as second parameter, we need to pass a string with the protocol over which our service is working. I'm assuming TCP, HTTP, and TCP under the hood. And then the port, the network port, where our service is being exposed. I'm assuming here port 80, which is the default HTTP port, so it's the most common port to use when we are exposing an HTTP server. And from this point onward, we should have our service registered and being advertised using MDNS. To finish, we are going to print here the local IP address assigned to this ASP32 on my local network, and that way, when we are doing getting the information about this service on the other ASP32, we'll be able to see if, for example, in this case, the IP address is correctly obtained. So, if we wanted to reach that server, that service directly using the IP address, we could do it. The main loop can be left empty here because we are not going to do any procedure. So, in my case, for this particular code, I've already uploaded it to my ASP32, and as you can see here, it basically connects to my Wi-Fi network and it prints here the IP address assigned to my unit. And this is the IP address that we should obtain in the other ASP32, the one that will be inquiring this MDNS service type. And basically, it should obtain alongside with other information, it should obtain this IP address. Now, we're going to look into the actual code of the inquirer. Basically, big parts of a big portion of the code will be the same. So we start again by including the MDNS library and the Wi-Fi.edge library. Same procedure here to define the credentials to connect this ASP32 to the Wi-Fi network. They need to be both connected to the same Wi-Fi network for this code to work. And then we are going to move on to the Arduino setup, doing again the same initialization steps, which is opening a serial connection and then connecting the ASP32 to Wi-Fi network. And from this point onward, things now will change a bit, because in this case we are going to inquire the MDNS service, so the initialization here will be slightly different. So as we have seen before, when we want to expose a service, to broadcast a service, to advertise a service using MDNS, we set up the responder and we define a hostname, and basically the services can be reached using that hostname that will be resolved to an IP address, which is the, let's say, the addresses that are used under the hood by the devices to communicate. But in this case, for this particular ASP32, I'm assuming that it is not exposing any service. So basically, it doesn't need to have a hostname of itself, and it doesn't need to be advertising or broadcasting anything, because it will, on the other way around, it will be inquiring a service. It will be doing a query to a service. So there was not much of a point of calling the begin method on the MDNS external variable and forcing us to pass there a hostname. So alternatively, what I did was looking into the actual implementation of that method in the Arduino core. And if we look under the hood in the method implementation, we can see that this lower level function from IDF, which is the official development framework from the ASP32, from Expressive, and it is a framework that Arduino core is built on top of. And basically, under the hood, this method MDNS underscore init, sorry, this function is called, and it basically allows us to initialize MDNS without forcing us to register a host, which means that we can still query the service, but we don't need to provide here a host name in order for our code to work. So in this case, as an alternative, I'm calling here this MDNS underscore init function. It takes no arguments, and if everything goes okay, it returns this constant, ASP underscore okay. Otherwise, if the result is different from this, we know that something failed starting MDNS, so we are finishing here our flow. From this point onward, we are assuming that everything goes fine, and basically we are going to start to query the MDNS service we want to reach. So to do so, we can call this query service method on our MDNS external variable, and in essence what we are specifying here is a service type that we want to query, because at this point, and that's why we are querying, we are trying to find out if there's some service of this type available. We don't know, or I'm assuming that we don't know, neither the host name or the IP address of the service provider, and in this case we are generically querying a service of a given type. And our type is basically composed by the service name, HTTP, and the protocol over which this service works, which is TCP. It's pretty much what we expose on the other side. Naturally, as you can see here, at this point, we don't know also the port, the networking port, where the service provider is going to expose the service. So that's precisely the information we want to get with this query. So again, just to recap, service name, and the protocol over which it works. As output, this method will return the number of services found as an integer. Naturally, we are going to store this in a variable, and the first thing we are going to do is checking if this number of services is equal to zero, because if it is, it means that our query did not return any services, so there's no point on trying to go through the information of those services, because there's no information to check, and we are being here more explicit and saying, okay, no services were found, so something might have happened. Note also that this number can be higher than one if you have more units or more hosts providing this service type in your network. Naturally, this can return a number bigger than one. In my case, I just have another unit, another SP32 unit exposing this service, but if I add more, this could return a number bigger than more. So that's why, as we are going to see here, we are going to loop, do a for loop, because if you want to try with more services, it's interesting to have this ready to handle multiple services of this type. So moving on our code, basically, if The else condition means that we have found some services. So the first thing we are doing here is printing the number of services we have found, and then we are looping through all the services with this for loop, which allows us to tackle or to cover the use cases where more than one service is found. Just then printing here a separator at the beginning and at the end, so we can clearly see the limits, the information of a given service. And then the only thing we need to do is starting to print the information. So to get the hostname, we call this method called hostname on our MDNS extern variable, and we pass the index of the service that we want to get this information. We don't have any other information to be able to say I want information of service A, B, or C. The only thing we have is an index that can that allow us to loop through all the services found. So these methods that we are going to use here, they are all index-based. So the first thing we are going to do, as I was saying, is getting the hostname of this service, of this iteration of the loop, of the service with the index we are covering now. So we call this hostname method, and we pass here the index for which we want to obtain the hostname of the service. To get the IP address, we call this IP method, same principle, passing the index of the service, and then the port by calling this port method, again passing the index of the service that we are getting the information from. And this is it. Obviously, the rest are prints just to make our code more readable, and again, in my case, I just expect to find information about one service, but I could find four more. Obviously, I'm just keeping the loop here without any information because I don't have anything else to do in the loop, but we could move this querying for the loop. So with my code, I'm assuming that the service provider will be running first, like you saw on my previous demonstration where I already had the service provider running. Obviously, if you want your ASP32 that is doing the query to be periodically do this call because the service might pop in the network and go down for some reason for your architecture, you could do this, for example, in a loop in a FreeRTOS task or something more fancy, but we are keeping things simple here. So I've already also uploaded this code to my other ASP32, as you can see here. Let me just reset this code so we can see it in action. So it is basically connecting, then it is doing the query. It takes like some seconds, and then it returns, in my case, that one service was found. Its hostname is ASP32, like we have named our hostname in the other ASP32, the service provider. The IP address matches the one. Let me just put here side by side as a recap. So as you can see here, let me just bring both. So as you can see here, it matches the IP address that was assigned to the service provider. So we could reach it now either by hostname or by IP address. And then we also have the port here, which is port 80, was the port that we have advertised. So we have all the information we need to reach the service provider. And in a realistic use case, for example, do HTTP request or any other service that was provided, it could be advertising an NTP service, socket service, whatever we wanted to provide. That's it, very simple. In the previous tutorial, we saw, in the previous video, we saw something similar, but the inquirer was a Python script. In this case, we are doing everything using MDNS devices. This allows us to improve our architecture. If we want to have a network with multiple devices, we now have a way of finding each other, of advertising services. So this will bring a lot of versatility to what we can do in our architectures. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you liked, please subscribe. I have also many other tutorials on my written blog, so please feel free to go there and explore it. Again, thank you for watching.